Hi, this is Captain Kangaroo, and I have a musical story for you. It is called Peter and the Wolf. In this story, we have a bird, a duck, a cat, Peter's grandfather, Peter himself, who was a little boy, a wolf, and some hunters. Now, the part of the bird is played by a flute. The duck is an oboe. A clarinet plays the part of the cat. Peter's grandfather is a bassoon. Peter himself is played by the strings. The wolf is played by the horns. And as the hunters and their guns, you will hear the big drums. And now, here is the story of Peter and the Wolf. Peter lived in a house behind a big gate overlooking a big green meadow. Now, early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow. On a branch of a big tree outside the wall sat a little bird. He is Peter's friend. All is quiet, chirped the bird gaily. Just then, a duck came waddling around. Oh, she was so glad that Peter had not closed the gate behind him and decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow. Thank you. The little bird flew down upon the grass, settled next to her, and shrugged his shoulders. "Now, what kind of a bird are you if you can't fly?" said he. To this the duck replied, "What kind of a bird are you if you can't swim?" and dived into the pond. They argued and argued, the duck swimming in the pond, the little bird hopping along the shore. Suddenly, something caught Peter's attention. He noticed a cat crawling through the grass. "Aha," thought the cat, "the bird is busy arguing. I'll just grab him." So quietly, she crept towards him on her velvet paws. "Look out," cried Peter, and the bird immediately flew up into the tree. While the duck quacked angrily at the cat. From the middle of the pond. Cat walked round and round the tree and thought to himself, "Is it worth climbing up so high? Well, by the time I get there, the bird will have flown away." Just then, Grandfather came out. He was angry because Peter had gone into the meadow. "It is a dangerous place," he said. "If a wolf should come out of the forest, then what would you do?" Peter paid no attention to his grandfather's words. I mean, after all, boys like him are not afraid of wolves. But nevertheless, Grandfather took Peter by the hand, locked the gate, and led him home. No sooner had Peter gone Then a big gray wolf came out of the forest. Saw the wolf, he climbed up the tree. The duck quacked. And oh my goodness, in her excitement, jumped out of the pond. No matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer and nearer, and catching up with her. And then he got her, and with one gulp, swallowed her. Now this is how things stood. The cat was sitting on one branch. The bird on another branch. Not too close to the cat. And the wolf walked round and round the tree, looking at them with greedy eyes. In the meantime, Peter, without the slightest fear, stood behind the closed gate, watching all that was going on. He ran home, got a strong rope, and climbed up the high stone wall. Now, one of the branches of the tree around which the wolf was walking stretched out over the wall. Grabbing hold of the branch, Peter lightly climbed onto the tree. Then Peter said to the bird, "Now listen, bird, fly down and circle around the wolf's head. Only take care that he doesn't catch you." The bird almost touched the wolf's head with his wings, while the wolf snapped angrily at him from this side and that side. That bird did worry that wolf. How the wolf wanted to catch him. But the bird was more clever, and the wolf simply couldn't do anything about it. Meanwhile, Peter made a lasso, and carefully letting it down, he caught the wolf by the tail and pulled with all his might. Feeling himself caught, the wolf began to jump wildly, trying to get loose. Peter tied the other end of the rope to the tree. And the wolf's jumping only made the rope round his tail tighter. The hunters came out of the woods. They were following the wolf's trail and shooting as they went.
But Peter, sitting in the tree, said, "Hunters, don't shoot. Look, Birdie and I have caught the wolf. Now come help us take him to the zoo." Can you just imagine the triumphant procession? Of course, Peter was at the head. After Peter came the hunters, leading the wolf. The procession, Grandfather and the cat. Grandfather tossed his head and he said, "Well, what if Peter hadn't caught the wolf? What then, eh?" Above them flew the bird, chirping merrily. "My, look, what brave fellows are we, Peter and I. Just look and see what we have caught." And if you listen very carefully, you could hear the duck quacking inside the wolf, because the wolf, in his hurry, had swallowed her alive. And that is the story of Peter and the Wolf.